Hello guys, MediEvil fan 147 back again today with part 2 of my No Chalice Let's Play of MediEvil 1. And for those of you who didn't see my last part, don't be fooled by the 2 next to the chalice icon in the corner. Yes, I'll admit I did collect 2 chalices by accident, just out of habit, but I didn't redeem the weapons for collecting them, but for some reason it still counted the chalices. So yep, today we are going to play the Asylum Grounds chalices. This is actually one of my favourite levels in the game. Love the music and love the level, and it's a real shame they didn't remake it in Resurrection, but I want to see how annoying it is without any chalices. So. It shouldn't be too bad. It's a very creative level. It's a shame they didn't recreate it. But, yeah, like I said in my Let's Plays, this is another level that haunted me for years. I could never get past the second riddle. I could not make head or tail of this whole face pillow where I had to turn all the faces and all that weird stuff. Oh, sorry. I was just wondering what happened there for a second. Okay, so, oh god, how hard are these mugs going to be with just the small sword? How many hits is it going to take? Oh yes, and because I'm now playing off an ISO again, there's no need for me to actually play off the keyboard. I'm just back to using my controller again, and I'm playing off an ISO instead of a CD-ROM this time. Like I said last time, because I've only got 3 USB slots, and I need 2 for plugging in my CD-ROM drive because I don't have a desk tray in this computer. So, and I also needed another USB slot for my microphone, so therefore I've used up 3 already, so I had to use my keyboard because I had no room for my USB controller. So, I'm back to using my USB controller again. Yeah, and as you may notice, because I'm playing the PAL version, the monks are wearing different coloured robes to the US version and the Japanese version. Yeah, they're wearing yellow robes in this, and in the other versions, they just wear white robes and yellow and red aprons. They're not too hard to defeat with the small sword, actually. I'm starting to wonder if I should collect the chalice in every level, but not actually redeem my weapon, but come think about it, I might defeat the purpose. I just won't collect the chalice. So, yeah, we'll just talk to Jack Green. I'm not going to make any more mistakes like that in the first 2 levels.
My name is Jack of the Green. I am the master of riddles, and this maze is my domain.
You are free. When I was younger, I probably didn't even know the answers to the riddles because I was so stupid and young.
So fiendishly difficult, so perplexingly complex that no man has ever solved them. Ha ha ha. Now, try my first riddle. At night they come without being fetched. By day they are lost without being stolen.
So yeah, when it's pretty obvious now that starts. When I was younger, I actually just couldn't make any tail the riddles. They made no sense to me whatsoever, and I just sort of ran around figuring out what I had to do. And pretty much, I just noticed you had to hit stars, and whenever you hit them, they just sort of broke and all that. So I thought that's how I figured out how to solve the first riddle. But then I could never get past the second riddle when I was younger. So yeah, we'll just have to destroy 5 stars. So yeah, there's 3 remaining already. This level shouldn't be too hard actually with no chalices, because the monks don't seem that bad with just the small sword. And yeah, by the way, Sky Hurricane, yeah, I did leave you a question in reply to comment saying, did you when you played the Ants Caves, or did you play Ants Caves? I didn't actually see that part, but when you did, well, you know, you must have actually got the chunk drumsticks, but I'm saying, did you actually free all the fairies but go to the Holy Heroes and not get your weapon? Because the thing is, I was going to get my weapon at the Holy Heroes that one time, because I would have gotten it without getting a chalice. But then when I noticed when I was watching your time device let's play that you didn't have the crossbow, so I'm assuming you didn't get your weapon from that level, so I think, just to be fair, I'm not going to as well, because I don't want to seem like I'm cheating in comparison to you. So, yeah, I'm just going to stick to not getting any more weapons. I'll get the chicken drumsticks, because I know you got the chicken drumsticks, so I'll get all the amber for the witch. Also, thank you very much for watching Let's Plays of MediEvil 1. Do you like MediEvil 2 as well? Like, I'm not sure, have you seen my MediEvil 2 one yet? Because, yeah, MediEvil 2, I'm definitely going to see that providing more of a challenge than MediEvil 1, like, although MediEvil 1 might be hard without getting a chalice, because MediEvil 2 you do find the odd weapon along the way without collecting a chalice, because I could always get a crossbow along the way, like a flaming crossbow in, what's it called? Yeah, Whitechapel. Oh god, I couldn't even remember my favourite level of the game for a second. And yeah guys, the previous level in the game was another level that had a favourite soundtrack of mine in the game, and the next one also has a favourite soundtrack of mine in the game. I love this level soundtrack. And it's so original to the game as well. It's just... amazing. I don't know why I said bleh before saying it was amazing, as if to say it's disgross. Just, I was going to say disgusting there and gross the entire time, I said disgross. So yep, yeah, that could serve as a hammer when knocking things down. I can just charge into things. Yeah, don't bother destroying that. So we've done the first riddle. Butter trifle. I always say that.
Return hither. You will not find my next conundrum so simple.
Yeah, and I'm so sorry about that mistake I made with MediEvil 2, like holding my controller too near the mic when playing. I'm trying to hold it further away from the mic today so you're not as annoyed by it.
I live for the crowd. Without it, I am nothing.
Right, so this is literally as far as I got when I was younger in the game. I could never get past this riddle, so the rest of the level was just a bit of a puzzle for me. I could never get past this gate here, and I could never get through this gate here to read that mouse. I always noticed there was money inside it, but I never saw a mouse when I was younger, but you can actually still see the mouse now without opening the gates. I don't know how I never remembered it being there. It's funny, I always remember things differently when you're older to when you were younger. You also have more of imagination when younger, because I guess when all these levels are much more wide open when I was younger, like I've said before, actually, come think of it. Also, Zelda Saggins, are you enjoying my No Child's Let's Plays of MediEvil yet? Yeah, you're enjoying them. I've not actually seen my first one, but I uploaded the other two quite late at night, I suppose, so... I know, I do tend to upload when everyone else is like in bed, so I always upload like in the middle of the night, because it's the only time I get a chance to, so that's why I mainly upload at the weekend, during the week when I'm at college, which I'll be back to soon, so my uploads might be infrequent again soon. I might not be uploading as frequently, but I'll try my best. If I'm not too tired after college, and if I've got time, I'll try my best. But it's just because family life is a bit hectic, I have such a demanding family, it's such a crowded house half the time, and everyone's so noisy, so...
Yes, it was a crowded I'm sure.
And then have a go at me from like late nights, it's because the only time I get a chance to have time to myself is when everyone else is in bed. Yeah, I'm still going to try and defeat the enemies like I said in previous part, just so that I can sort of emulate, like just impersonate playing the level properly, but get no reward for it. Right, so that's just done the second riddle already, out of technically five. He says four riddles, but we get a fifth one, which is pretty much just the chess piece. That's not really a riddle, it's more of a puzzle.
Skin like the sea.
Ah, God, did you hear my finger crack there again? Terrible crack my fingers.
Yet vermin frighten me.
I might have the first time I encountered this riddle. For some reason, I thought it sounded completely different to the first two, because he sounded different the way he said it, because I'm not used to hearing him say that riddle. So I only ever heard him say the first two when I played much younger, so it's quite weird to hear him say that for the first time when I played it. And it was also quite weird to see these cats moving, because they don't move up to this point. They stay completely still the rest of the... Well, start of the game, start of the level. So. Also, I have no idea why in the other versions of the game that the monks wear different robes. I have no idea why they did that, but I quite like the look of the yellow ones. I don't mean to sound like I'm showing favouritism, I just prefer the look of the yellow robes. The prototype versions of the monks look so funny though, they have such goofy looking faces, and they don't look very zombified at all, so I quite like the final look of them. So the only reason I'm actually killing them right now is because they're probably going to annoy me while I'm freeing the mouse and leading up to the elephants, so I'm just getting them out of the way so that they don't annoy me. Oh yeah, and also you may have noticed, like whenever you're near a chalice and you're defeating an enemy, you'll notice when you kill them, their souls actually go in the direction of the chalice. And that was something I only just discovered myself like a year or so ago. Yeah, well maybe a couple of years ago. Time does go fast, I can't lose track of when things actually happened. So, but yeah, I actually only noticed that like a couple of years ago, and there's still new things I'm discovering in MediEvil 2. I mean, like only like a couple of years ago, I discovered in Wolfram Hall in MediEvil 2 that there was actually a way in to the, I guess you can see the kitchen area, where the first Renfield is, the encounter is down on the hand where you get the key. I didn't know you could actually kill that Renfield, so that's actually very useful, because that means you can actually get the chalice before you actually enter the second last room with the vampires in it, so that's just mostly for timekeeping really, so I'm just rambling now, so sorry. So yeah, we'll just open... I didn't get Sarin. Shit. Yeah, we'll just go get Sarin now. That won't be any biggie. And I'm still glad that my controller seems to be doing well. I don't know if it's the fact I've just kept pressing the buttons over and over. It's just sort of like... fixed itself. I don't know what I've done, but like I was saying before in like previous parts, my controller has to be have the buttons really pressed hardly to actually respond. But right now I'm just pressing them just softly and ordinary, and they're working fine. So it's... Oh god, the buttons. This particular controller has very loud buttons when I'm pressing it. So I'm so sorry. I'm trying to tap them as far away from the microphone as possible. You might hear a tiny bit of tapping, but hopefully it won't be as irritating as it was in part 2 of my MediEvil 2 one. I'm just gonna sprint past that. you don't even get percentage of Chalice for that anyway, so. See, the thing is, I want to build up percentage of Chalice, but I'm gonna try not to collect it. Well, by try not to collect it, I mean, like, I am actually not wanting to collect it, but I wasn't even going to collect it in the graveyard in Cemetery Hell, but just out of habit, I did. Oh, I do that every time. I never do this riddle, like, smoothly. I always keep thinking I'm done by the time I've got the Chaos Rune, and I just want to go back to the Jack of the Green, but this time I actually didn't go back to Jack of the Green. I just assumed I'd already freed the mouse. I'm wondering how many levels I'm playing this part. I played quite a lot in the previous part. I might play a few this time. Again, I don't know how long this Let's Play will be. Will it be done in only just a few parts? Come think of it. Oh, we stopped coming up with notifications. That's one thing I hate about this new computer. When it comes up with new notifications, it automatically comes off of EPSXE. And if I'm moving, well, I click off of EPSXE. He'll keep on moving until I next click on it, so that's annoying. So sorry for that random, goofy movement there that looked very risky and stupid. A little note has popped up. You may have heard it, actually. It may have gone do-da-da-doon there. If anyone can tell me to stop those, I'd really appreciate it, because it's really annoying. I hate Windows 10. I wish I could divert all the way back to Windows 7. Windows has sucked since Windows 7. Windows 8.1 was alright, I suppose, but Windows 8 sucked.
In truth, it was obviously an elephant. This time, however, I almost pity you. The answer to my next vexing enigma has
eluded the finest minds of a whole generation. Come to me.
Tolerate the moon and stars, I can't abide the sun. Banish me with torchlight and you'll see me turn and run.
So this is just darkness in general. Or stars. Banish me with torchlight and you'll see me turn and run. So that... I could be star. I don't know. It's... I think the answer is just darkness, but I don't know, it could be stars. I like how the grass actually shows more green with the NVIDIA colours on this laptop, because on my old laptop I noticed that they showed more yellow, and whenever I played it on the PS1 I'm like, why is the colours always so green, but then when you play it on the emulator they look much more duller. So I don't know, I like the settings I have right now though, they look more true to the colours in the PS1. Apart from the fact on the PS1 the actual textures are much more pixelated and everything, whereas it's much more smoothed out in EPSXE with the settings you can have. Which I sort of take advantage of. I like uploading just in HD now because I'm very picky. I'm not picky when it comes to watching other people's videos. I don't care if it's in bad quality and everything. I just love watching other people's videos, but I'm very obsessive when it comes to my own channel. I just like everything to be perfect, even though I'm far from it. But just as perfect as possible. Man, my comment is already perfect. I mean, did you hear my medieval T1? Constant button tapping that I didn't even notice. And my comment is with Alex, like, bless her though, but there's just so many things that go wrong when I'm with her, just like, she's easily distracted, and my sister sort of distracts her all the time in that, and just, she talks about nothing to do with the games half the time that we're playing, so, I suppose it's kind of fun, because it just shows she's been herself. And technically, just our approach with comedies is just having fun while playing a game. Was it more to the point of this game? I'm getting diverted again. I'm getting this bad. So yeah, we just pretty much have to push all of these lit boxes up to these little, I guess you could say, glass windows. And then pretty much that beams light in all directions, and then we sort of beam back up to the top again. Because we've caused light or something like that. So I think, yeah, this is the last puzzle in the game. Well, not in the game, in the level, sorry. So, well, technically the last riddle. We've got a little puzzle of chess next, which isn't that big.
Blast you. It took me ages
to talk to Jack of the Green. And magically teleporting monks appear.
Outrageous as it seems, my vast intellect has been matched by
your badly decomposed brain. Turn it once and I shall give you your prize. And I've ended the level with just losing a tiny bit of health. That's not bad at all, considering I've got no chances. I come think of it, by this point, I should have 5 life balls. If I have gotten all the chances up to it, I think. You get 3 light balls from all heroes.
Think you're so clever, don't you? Here you are, Sir Clever Clogs. I grant you free passage through my maze. Find your own way out.
Rigilant. So, when it comes to MediEvil 2, that's probably one thing that'll be an advantage, as I've mentioned in previous parts. But for those of you who have not seen previous parts, oh yeah, like, the chalice is solid and you have no idea how tempting it is to collect that, but I'm not going to get it. I'll just top up my daggers and just stare at that collectible chalice that's so tantalizing to collect, but I'm not going to collect it. Whoa, psych! Well, I'm not getting it. And also, for the first time ever in a MediEvil Let's Play, I actually got a copyright notice in a commentary video. I've never actually gotten one yet in my commentary videos of MediEvil. My music must have played too loud in Skirtle Fields because I picked up the Skirtle Fields soundtrack, so pretty much I just re-rendered it with the volume a bit lower and then it never got recognized. That was fine. So, whoops. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, I thought because the sword sort of just swings in every direction, it might be harder here because it might not detect what direction I'm hitting it in, but it seems to be going fine. I think all the other pieces go in every direction except the green one. The green one only goes diagonal. And I won't need the other life vials there. This game is much more generous with life vials in pretty much in every way compared to Medieval 2. The life vials give you much less health in Medieval 2, and there's also less of them. Also, the life vials are darker looking in Medieval 2. I mean, no, it's same with the life balls. And also, life fountains don't respawn in Medieval 2. Medieval 2 is just harder in general. Literally everything about it is harder. I think that's one of the things that was criticised about it. The critics, but it's as good a game as it is. I think that's just one thing people criticised about it, it's just how ridiculously hard it is. There we go, we never got a chalice. Awesome. So we got to the asylum grounds, chaliceless. Oh dear. Just realise inside this asylum this is going to be a nightmare. But bring it on. I'm definitely saving game though. I mean, fuck that shit. There we go. I really wish they kept in the intro for this level. They removed an intro sequence to that level, which I thought was pretty cool. I don't know why they removed it. It was quite a cool one. So, this shouldn't be too bad. We're quite used to killing zombies with swords. The only downside is the zombies actually, even the smaller zombies, take more health off you in this level than they did originally. So, we're just going to be super careful, guys. Oh god, I never looked at a shield. No wonder I'm still getting hit when I'm shielding. I'll just gather them all up and try to hit them all in one go. Here we go. Okay, this technique still seems to work with a small sword, because I usually use the broadsword in this level, so... Yeah, this technique seems to work, so that's fine. Step back. Oh, jeep. Jesus, so good. Because this level's already hard at the best of times. I have seen myself losing this one before, even, like, when off-camera. This one's actually a pretty hard level. I've gone pretty lucky when recording myself for this one. So, I don't know how I'm going to be without good weapons. We already lost life ball. And with less life balls actually by this point, that's gonna be annoying. I quite often try to prolong this level as long as possible so that when I actually do it, I'll have more life balls. But I'll just try and get it away now, see how I do it. I'm dreading the next room. The next room's the most annoying of them all. Because you get the bigger zombies and you have bats and just everything that's annoying. So I'm not even being that careful. I don't know what I'm on about. I'm just saying I'm just gonna be super careful here, guys, but I'm not being that careful at all. So I'm just running around like an idiot. I'm not wasting my daggers, that's the only ammunition I'm going to have for the whole game. I want to save money on them. Just trying to think of many enemies I'll need to defeat with the Tomo daggers. I could probably just defeat the pumpkin serpent with my sword. I do that with the broadsword, so it might work just as well with my small sword. And the ghost ship, I don't think he'll be that hard either, because you just defeat him with the club anyway, so... You pretty much just light the cannons for him. But the actual skeletons annoy you throughout the whole part. That's what's going to be challenging, I think. Oh, I've lost two life balls. Come on, Steven, you can do this. I'm actually really questioning whether or not... Oh, no! I just realized I've got no crossbow here. I usually fire crossbows all over the place to defeat these bats. Oh, fuck. This is going to be annoying. I'm just going to wave my sword all over the place to see if that'll be as effective. No! Gosh, 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 gosh. No, don't you dare. Oh, oh. Yes, yes, give that me, give that me, give me. So, thank gosh, I'm so glad that they're overdoing it with the life vials in this time. Usually I think they really are too generous with life vials in this game, but nope, they're not too generous when you're not collecting chalices. I think that's why they do it. Like, just in case you're doing a no chalice playthrough, you will give you lots of chalices. We'll give you lots of chalices. We'll give you lots of life vials. And here they come. Just gather them all up. Oh, even when fully charged, your sword doesn't hit them in one hit. Kill them one hit. Oh, jeez. Oh no. I'm not even being careful. I should be being careful. Come on. Come on. No. Slipping heck. Well, you can make it through the same in one piece with just a small sword. You should be so proud of yourself, if you do. This is a really pain in the ass level. Oh god. Whoa, that didn't even hit any of them. Come on. Oh god, they're still coming. Will this torment end? Oh gosh. No. Right. Oh gosh, I'm really panicking now. Oh, I know my club! I think I could sacrifice my club here. Yeah. The club will be good, isn't it? Or will it? Oh gosh. Okay, I'm just going to be very careful here. I'm just going to take my time. And just hit with them when I know I can. So I'm not wasting my health. There we go. Oh fuck, there's still more falling! Oh Jesus. Oh gosh. I'm actually sweating right now. I'm really panicking. Just two more zombies. And you can just see me. One more zombie! He didn't even die, what the hell? Come on, you've got no other friends to back you up right now, so you might as well give in. Come off it. Yes! Don't know what money is going to do for me health-wise. I'll be careful down here too. Oh jeez, I've not got much health to deal with. Stay away from me. I've got a new shield though, so that'll be helpful. Kinda. And I think you get life files down here, so that's handy. So I'm questioning whether or not I'll return to graveyard, but then that'll be cheating, I suppose, if there's no chalice at place. So I'm just going to try and tolerate by not returning to the graveyard. I might have to though if I get really bad. But if I get a life out in this level and a life file here, I might just make it. Hold on. Gosh, it's freaking insane in here. Oh gosh, I'll just try and defeat them with a club too. This is freaking mental. Heh, get it. There we go. Yes! There we go. Thank god. Oh god, there's more of them? Will this torment never end? Oh god, more life vial. Another life vial. More life vial. That's kind of stupid. But, I'll just use my club on them. The club was pretty effective. And I'll just use my sword on the zombies. That'll be fine. Oh, come off it. There we go. For once, I'm actually making good use of my shield, I think. Okay, one more enemy, I'm hoping. Yes! So just one more room. And you don't even have to kill many in here before the box falls down. I literally just have to get 100% chalice and then just open that box and then they'll all explode. Right, how much more shield have I got? Not much. I'll just have to make the most of it though. Fucking hell. I just gotta run around making sure the cannon doesn't hit me as well. So many obstacles in this level. Come off it. Come on. You can stay, Stephen. Oh, I've only got one more hit at the club left. Two more hits. Okay, I think I've made good use of the club, but nah, I'm sticking throwing daggers. I'm not going near them with my sword. Oh, that was useful. Okay, the daggers are slightly effective, so I'm going to use my daggers. Oh, why can't they walk into the lava like they do in Resurrection? That'd make my troubles a lot less. I say I'll make things a lot easier, but then I think I'll make my troubles a lot less. I'll just make sure I'm standing over here so none of them can get me. Okay, so that's okay. Come on, once you got 100% chalices, it'll be fine. Well, once you kill this one. There we go. Just stay well back. Yes! Wow! I made it through Inside the Asylum without any good weapons. Oh my god, I'm so proud of myself. That is a major achievement for me. Thank you guys for encouraging me to do this. They've pretty much got no club at all. Well, that's a big step for me. Dun, 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 dun. Well, that's one level I've been worrying about out the way. Excuse me, I'm just going to turn my heat off. It's roasting in here. Or is it just because I was panicking? You can't put me, you lanky windbag, armour. Ah, that's what. But then the army locked up on you with all these nutty thoughts. It's been terrible. I've not managed to get a sense of anyone in weeks, and I got the totally wrong. Oh, God, sorry. Fell on my chair. I swear I've not been drinking.
You have a good look around, lad. Xanax left some stuff lying about that I think you might find useful.
I can safely say I'm fair chuffed with that. So, what one should we do next, I wonder? I think Pumpkin Gorge will be a good one to do next. Pumpkin Gorge, Pumpkin Serpent.
Captain Fortescue, it's me, Canny Tim.
I made the habit of getting the chalice again. I'll not get the weapon, don't worry. No. Don't want it. So that was just a habit again. Okay, I did not get the weapon. Good. Yes. That was very close. I'm sorry. See, I can't be trusted. I'm too used to playing a certain way. I have to put a disclaimer again that I did that by accident. So yeah, I've got three chalices now, but doesn't count. There we go, now we can do Pumpkin Gorge. Not George, Gorge. Pumpkin George hasn't been around these parts for years. There we go. How will this level do without the chalice? Oh god. Whoops. Well, I've got a club now at least. Make good use of that. And I'll... might as well go in here now, I suppose. Because I won't be coming back for the chalice anyway. I could just sprint through this level, come think of it. Oh no, oh, good. Got a life file. Do we get life out from another room? Yeah, I think we do, but I'll leave it. There's a life out nearby, I'll just get it there. And yeah, we'll just kill the pumpkin. I have a bit of practice with defeating the pumpkins, no chalice, because I just did it with MediEvil 2, and the pumpkins in that game are much harder. So, oh shh, blah. Hold on. Oh, there's a life out here, but I wonder if I could do a stunt that I usually do. Yes, I did it. Can I go back over? No, can't. Okay, that sucks. I hate how I even feel to do that in my long play. It's surprising when I can't do that, because it is something I genuinely can do. Come on, come on. Oh, come on, game. Don't lag on me at a time like this. You've been doing so well up till now. Hang on, guys. Okay. I just started recording again, hopefully I was hoping that would stop it lagging, but nah, it's still lagging a bit. Okay, hopefully when I exit this room, it will stop lagging. Yeah, it seems to be working fine now. I'm not sure if it was something to do with that room, but come on. There's one life file in here, but I don't really need it. Oh, what didn't mean to glide, I was trying to avoid it. I was going to come back for later if I needed it. Sorry about that lag there, I could have sworn... I don't know. Don't know why I've got such a slow ladder, but it's supposed to be a good one, this one, but never mind. Maybe it's just Super Sexy being a bitch to me. Dun, 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 dun. Back off, I'm getting health. That I don't even... I could have not needed if I hadn't tried to confront him. I'll just say, I don't know if I'd want to play the game without a chalice again. It feels so frightening, to be honest. I was really thought I was going to lose Inside the Asylum. And I'm sorry I got the chalice again. It really is just a habit. I'm not trying to pull a fast one, honestly. Even notice I left the level, like, left all the heroes without the weapon again. So, as long as I do that, that's... doesn't matter. So pretty much I go up here just to get the earth rune, to open the gate to get the star rune, to open the star rune gate to get the time rune, to pretty much just leave, because that's pretty much all I've got to do here. I don't have to return to get any chalice or anything. And at least I will actually not be... I'll be more persuaded not to collect it if I have to go so far back to collect it. So it was just when it was in among all other collectible items, I just grabbed it among other stuff when I was inside the asylum. Like, I just grabbed the money, rune, chalice, and then topped up health. I never thought, honestly, it's just a habit, seriously. There we go, got started now. I remember this, well, last year now, I keep thinking it's all 2015. I remember last year I made sure that I did this part of my Let's Play for Halloween. Like, I played Pumpkin Gorge and Pumpkin Serpent for Halloween. So we're pretty much almost done Pumpkin Gorge. I actually feel like it feels easier with it, Chalice, because I've got less to worry about, then it'd probably benefit me in future levels if I did get the Chalice. Oh, come off it. Well, at least there's a life file I can get after this point. I'll get that and not bother defeating the pumpkins that are with it. But I'll have to defeat these ones that are out in my hair for getting the time rune. Come on. Die, 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 die. Right, how much club do I have? I've got a bit of club, I'll use that on this. That'll make it go faster. I'll use it on it a bit, I won't use too much of it. I'll use it till about like the 20 point, and then I'll try not waste any more of it. I like how you can actually get a club relatively frequently in this game, because I used to keep thinking like they give you a club way too often when you already have a hammer at this point in the game, but I'm kind of glad they keep giving us clubs for times, I guess, because they sort of like substitute for the hammer. And I think they're the same strength as the hammer, but except the hammer's permanent. Dun. Together yet? Nope, not quite. Oh god, I didn't keep track of how much percentage. Oh well, that's that club gone then. Sorry about that. I'm such a dozy bitch, I'm sorry. Okay, surely that's low enough now. There we go. So we'll go through this way. Actually no, we'll go this way. Actually no, we can't go that way because we don't have a club, so. Yeah, the level is still completable, but that means I can't get the money that's in among the boulders. Because I've got no club to knock it down with. Well, just run past him, Steven, you don't need to kill him, you don't need to kill him. Just get to the end, get to the end, get to the end. And I just lost life, just lost half a life bar, so that's good. So that's me survive Pumpkin Gorge, is that a chalice? I hope I don't keep making the same mistake with MediEvil 2, that I keep getting the chalices, but... Oh, actually, I really hope I don't in MediEvil 2, because if you collect a chalice, you're not allowed to leave the professor's lab without your weapon, because if you actually... go to leave to the next level without collecting your weapon, the professor comes over to you and says, you haven't picked up your weapon yet, so you have no choice but to get it. So yeah, we'll play Pumpkin Serpent now. Right. Ooh, come in. Well, this boss is never usually that hard anyhow, so but I'll probably find it much more difficult. Like, oh, and hopefully I'm not going to make the same mistake I did in my Let's Play this, because I was talking way too much that I completely forgot to pick up the Dragon Gem, even though I went back to the witch for it. The Dragon Gem was even put right in front of me, and I walked right away from it. I didn't even bother to walk into it. And that was honestly not deliberately. I'm really that ditzy. It's unbelievable. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, we won't bother talking to the witch yet. We don't have to talk to her, like, to begin with. We can just go up to her afterwards. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, those pods are going to take quite a few hits, aren't they? Well, maybe not then. This is not too bad. The pumpkins aren't too hard with the sword, actually. Dun, dun. I'll probably start feeling it once I'm actually like the Shadow Demons and that, you know, harder enemies. But once I've got the Dragon Armor, I might make good use of that, because the Dragon Armor is a pretty damn good weapon. So I probably won't be... I don't know, the game might be really hard up till I get to the Gals Gauntlet. Then I could just use the Dragon Armor and everything. The Ghost Ship might still be pretty hard. Then again, that might not be too hard if I just rush a level without defeating any enemies. Then again, I might still defeat some to provide myself a bit of a challenge, like I said. Yep, and I can't get enough shields at this point. Love this music. I used it in one of my YTPs. Off of Hunchback Notre Dame. Oh, actually, I might put the link down below to that Hunchback Notre Dame YTP that I made recently. I make three parts of this franchise called Frollo is a Slut series. I know, a weird title. If you don't know what YTPs are, then you'll understand why. If you don't know what YTPs are, you'll probably wonder why it's got such a weird title. YTPs are just weird, just full stop. So, yeah, I've got a Frollo is a Slut series, and part 2 and 3 in particular, or no, 3 in particular, I have major medieval references in it, if you want to check that out. I even have a whole sequence of making it look like that Frollo has actually got a life bar with life bottles. He picks a life bottle up, he picks up a chaos rune, he picks up money, he kills a shadow demon, he kills 3 zombies, and I really enjoyed making that whole sequence. I felt so creative when doing it. I even made him fall off a ledge and lose a life bottle. Dun. If I forget to put the link down below, just mention it in the comment section if you watch it. And, I always put the link to my other channel down below, so you can just click the link to my other channel and find it through there. It's called, what is it called? Slife Frollo is Gullible. I think that's what it's called. That. So look for videos like that. It'll say on the thumbnail, yep, still slut, so. In case you're wondering. Sorry about promoting my own videos, but I just thought people who like medieval will definitely like that. And I'm not making fun of medieval, because I absolutely love medieval. I mean, I actually only ever tend to make YTPs of things I like, so it's just a bit of a laugh. I just sort of overemphasize the things I like about it, really. Stop it. Oh, well, actually, come think of it, there is life vials in a cell after defeat boss, so that's going to be handy. Whoa. Come to think of it, I think I've seen Let's Plays, I think it's by Atherix. I don't know if he uploads to YouTube anymore, but I remember seeing his playthroughs of Medieval, and he actually used his small sword quite a lot to save on spending money on ammunition. So I think he'd be quite alright at doing a no-tell Let's Play, because he seemed to get through it alright, so. Oh, come off, even with a small sword, he's not that hard. look how much health that took off with just one swing of the sword. One, hold down it square and swing of the sword. Come on. You got this. Whoa. Sorry. Come on, you got this. Stop turning your tentacles towards me. Oh, fuck you. Stop. Oh, okay, that's annoying. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, maybe you are breathing a bit of a challenge then. I get it. Okay. What, he's even... Don't you dare top up your health. Yes, I forgot he does top up your health if you don't hit him after a while. And I've never had to take this long to defeat him before. Come on, just whack away him. I don't care if I'm losing tons of health. I'm going to get him. Come on. There we go, he's dead. I know I poorly wasted tons of health there, but I'll get life vials. It's fine. So that was me defeating a boss with a small sword. Get out of the way! Oh my god, I lost tons of health there just so unnecessarily. Wait, I still have life left over from that fountain. Awesome. So, next we will do the Ants Caves and maybe the Enchanted Earth. I'll see how I feel. Maybe do all that in one part. So we'll go up to her now. Since we've not actually used the Shadow Effect yet, we can use it now. Whoops, move a bit closer.
A most edifying spec.
Yeah, we'll skip her now because this is not like story mode. There we go. So we've got both the Dragon Gems, so now both Crystal Caves and Gal's Gauntlet are officially completable. Which I did not know about when I was younger, and come to think of it, I am actually going to go down that well, because I think there's a life file. I think there's either one or two. There's definitely one life file down here. Oh no, there's two. Even better. And should I top up Throne Daggers? Nope, I'm okay with Throne Daggers. All good. I've not got 100%, that's good. I was going to say, I'll have to walk around that very carefully, but nah. I've not got 100% anyhow, so I can walk right through it. So that's this one done. That's another level done and dusted. This feels so awesome. It actually does feel kind of rewarding not collecting any chalices, knowing I can make my way through the game, being strong, working through without any handicaps. Handicaps, is that the right term? I think handicaps is a bad thing, isn't it? There we go. So now we're going on to the Enchanted Earth. But we'll do the Ants Caves first. Which I'll not get a weapon for. Well, apart from the chicken drumsticks. Yes, good coffee. Aw, crap, I just remembered the Ant Queen. Oh, bugger off. Got no sword to defend myself from, yes. There we go. We can just automatically use it again. The Shadow Talisman. Just Shadow Talisman. Witch's Talisman, sir. I'll skip everything she's saying. Forgive me, just an old lady's little joke. What's wrong with you? How do you feel? So I'm just quoting lines from Bond. There are some genuine sick people here who require more attention or something. Grumble, grumble, what have you done to me? Moan, moan, moan. So I'm wondering, I'm going to feel the Furies, because it doesn't count as collecting a chalice, but when I go to Hollyoaks, again, I'm just not going to redeem my weapon. So I'll play this this level as I normally would. Yep, shut up. Creepy music. This level used to terrify me when I was younger. Like, it really did. But I think... Oh god, I went really American there, I think. But I think... Greenwich scared me a lot more when I was younger. That music's just terrifying in Greenwich. Fireflies. Oh my gosh, Last of Us copied MediEvil. Sorry, I'm all joking. Yeah, so we go right first. I officially just remember how to play this level now. I remember I got like dead ends for years, I kept running in circles to level, but I officially just remember the route now. Oh, screw you. Right, so I just hope there's not too many opportunities this level to knock down these boulders, because I've only got a club. So if I run out of that, I'm screwed. So I might actually use that sparingly, come think of it. And I might not focus on killing the ants, so I'll just run through the level. And we'll only kill them if they get my way. And oh yeah, I'll have to make sure to get amber, come think of it. But I can get that with sword. And I can daring dash into these. You don't have to use a hammer to let them free. There you go. Wow. Oh, get away. I don't think any weapons will be actually good on Ant Queen other than the daggers, so I'll just have to make do with that. Might be just a longer process to defeat Ant Queen, but I'll just have to be a bit more patient and dodge her attacks quite well. So I'm just making sure I get everything here. I'm pretty sure there's money under one of these ones. Yeah, that one, so yeah. But it's further in level, and I think we take the next left and there's a light fountain. Go away, Noif. MediEvil's more important. Yeah, another Noif popped up just now. Alcohol, 120% trial. Yes, okay, I get it. Yeah, topped up health now, so just tell these. No, not you, I meant the ants. So. Okay, three collected, four remaining. Right, so I'm making sure I'm definitely going to get the chicken drumsticks. Because that's not even a Hall of Hero weapon. Come off it. Oof, this music gets eerie. I love it though. Don't know why I love the feeling of being scared at times. It's like thrill factor of it. So, 3 out of 6. So that's 3-3. So yeah, he's going to grant us passage to the Holy Heroes, but we're not going to get a weapon. So I just got to get two more of these, and then I can just sprint through this level. Dun, 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 dun. Whoops. Oh, just one more bit of amber. I just want to make sure I'm missing no money, because I really want some money bags. And I swear that wasn't meant to be a reference to Spyro. I couldn't even think of what I was supposedly referencing there. There we go. Had to go around in the other circle there because I swore I wasn't going anyway. So yeah, turn left. Get my way, bitches. And I never usually defeat the Ancestor level anyway, so this level's pretty much the same for me. And we were in the last room already, so like in the last room there is two fairies, so yep, we've not missed a single fairy. Ah, to hell with you. Again, I'm meaning the ants. I think we only have one more bit of amber to get for the witch. Yep, that's it. So, yeah, we've got enough, we don't need any more. So, just ran into another piece there. They give you plenty of bits of amber to play, so that's good. I remember actually the first time I actually didn't get enough amber for the witch. I was quite scared at a reaction because I never noticed I didn't get enough amber. Just like, what is this? I said 7 pieces of amber. No reward for you, you little squat. Something like that, she says something like that. So, yeah, she's quite cow if you don't get all of her amber. Stop it. Get out of the way.
Go away.
Oh, it's just another one with a piece of amber. So yep, just go straight down and defeat the Ant Queen. Oh, stop it! There we go. So another note came up that came off the game. So. There we go. Full health for defeating the Ant Queen. Could have more, but hey, I'll have to have it. So, yeah, I've got the club still. So, oh, I've got plenty of percentage of it too. So I'll just use the club to, as a replacement of the hammer. And I've got no shield to defend myself. Sugar. This is going to be trouble. Yes, that was a reference to Bug's Life game. This is going to be trouble. Oh. Ah, just throw them. Oh dear, that's taken off nothing at all. Oh, that's not promising at all. Wonder how good the sword will be in her. What if I keep jumping and using my sword? Her attacks are really hard to dodge. Tell me, Hurricane, how long did you have to redo any levels? Because I'm still to watch them properly, honestly. I promise you I will watch your No Child's Let's Plays properly sometime. Just I need to find the time to do it. God, this is not looking promising. So. Oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Wonder if I can actually hit her with the club. Will that work? She can't get hit with the club. Oh my god. Oh, for crying out loud. She's gonna take forever to die. Crying out loud. I think that's pretty much the only bad thing about doing the No Child's Let's Plays. It's gonna take forever to do bosses. maybe if they're not even necessarily gonna be that difficult, they're just gonna take a long time to defeat. Wait, okay, I'll just switch back to throwing daggers again because I think they were being slightly effective. Oh, for a second there I thought she was ready to be hit. Oh, sugar. Oh, gosh, I'm not even halfway yet. Come on, we'll be here all day if we have to. Even though I don't have all day. So I've got Alex coming over again, and I'm still up at 20 to 8 in the morning, and she's coming over at 4 in the afternoon, so I'm going to have to make sure I get some sleep before I see her. Oh, for those of you who watch my PS1 Let's Plays and don't know Alex, she tends to join me in my Let's Plays of The Weakest Link and Walking Dead and all that stuff. And she's also just a friend in general. Come on. Oh, you bloody ants. Okay, so I'm almost lost 2 life balls, but I'm not doing too bad considering I've taken almost half a life bar off her. If only there was a faster way to do this. I mean, I can't hit her with a club. I can't hit her. Well, I can hit her with a sword, but it's time consuming trying to do so. If we can actually just. Okay, Come on, there we go. They won't be able to start me now, so come on. That's ridiculous. You know, I might actually have to return to graveyard, but then again, I might not. Because they are relatively generous with health in this game, so if I run low in health, I'll just be careful in Shattered Earth and just run and get health before I do anything else. And even after you defeat the boss, they give you lots of health, so it's pretty good. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, that's good. You spaz in there, and then I'll just I'll just defeat the boss. Come on, there we go. Just repetitively throw daggers at her. That might be more effective. And she loses 5% at a time. Jesus. There we go. I think I'm doing alright, it's just Tim consuming. And yes, I'm well aware I free-dealt fairies. It's only because I was wanting to play level as normal, but not be rewarded for it. So I think that's actually, like, makes more sense to us. So I think I'm just trying to put myself in the clear. Oh, the guy's roasting in here. I wonder if it's just the nerves. Oh gosh. Gosh, I can't concentrate with all the other ants distracting me. Okay, I'm gonna try to keep all the other ants distracted until she like rises up, and then I'll just destroy them, and then get a chance to hurt with hit them distracting me. Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. I'm staying surprisingly calm. I'm usually very panicky when it comes to running low in health in games. This is almost like I'm in a zombie apocalypse with no way out. That's kind of how this feels like right now. Well, actually no, not quite as bad because it's not real. But right, so I'll probably take three more times, I think. So I started off this battle with full health. I've almost lost 3 life balls, and she's almost defeated, so this is actually quite promising. I might end the level with like half a life bar left. But I did start off the boss not being that careful, so now that I'm being careful, maybe I might just make it. I'm just trying to work this out in my head as- oh! Perfect! There we go. So 5555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555 Oh god. Be careful, Steven. Yeah, I guess you don't know by name, my real name's Steven. Oh no. Oh, Jesus. I'm running out of throwing daggers! Oh god, I thought this looked promising, but obviously not. The fact that things are collapsing on top of me is not helping. You know what, I'm actually probably going to have to adjust myself to use my arm. Oh god. I'm just... Oh, Jesus. You know, I might just make this. And no more. Okay, I'm just going to try and dodge these ants. I'm not going to bother trying to defeat them because that'll be a waste of ammo. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. God, I'm actually sweating right now. Honestly, I'm really panicking. Gosh. Come on. Come on, you can do this. Oh, you idiot. Sorry. Lift up, please. Let's lift up right now so I can hit. God, please. Please, please, please. Please. Come on. No, don't miss. Yes! Thank. Fuck. Hell yeah, please. Get me out here. Get me out here. I'm a celebrity. Get me out here. Yes! 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 Oh my god, I wish you could actually see my hand right now. My controller is roasting and my hands are sweating. Oh my god.
Bless me, if it isn't Daniel.
Lord of the Rings.
Hold still, and I'll remove the shriek spell.
I high five myself. Right, he's going to grant me passage to the Hall of Heroes, but I'm not going to go.
Lovely Amber.
I know, Amber's a lovely person. Whoever Amber is. Ugh, I'm not sure what use I'm gonna make of that. Can you use them on the Shadow Demons? If I can, I'm definitely using them. Filthy and scam! Yeah, I'm gonna skip what you're saying. And yeah, I am going to Lyra's, like I said. I'm just gonna keep repeating myself because people happen to not hear me because I have a very fast voice. But that's it. I'm not gonna reward myself. Just. Bye bye. There we go. Woom, 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 woom. I'm saying woom over and over, come think of it. Still got a full life ball after that. Thank God. Yes, definitely saving game. Gosh, it's not been taking that long to play the game at all. Yep, go back into the Enchanted Earth. Skip the cutscene again. Oh, let's see if we can get this. Oh no, I got another boss. This level. Oh, these ones are going to suck the ass. So. Right. Get in my way. Can't kill them with a chicken drumstick, so be careful, Steven, be careful. Come on. Oh, sugar. Sorry. I'm a bit ahead of myself right there. Don't you dare. Sorry. Dun, dun. Okay, okay. Tellies. Don't hit me when I try to top up my health. It's not fair. That's appropriate, not fair. And there's still a life vial at this point, so okay, just. Ugh. I'm not gonna have full health for the bosses. Oh god, I'm really worried. Dun, 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 dun. I'm actually kind of feeling like a kid again. It almost feels like I'm back to really being stuck at this game and finding it really hard. And this is kind of the feeling I had when I was collecting chalices when I was younger. Or maybe, I can't remember, when I was younger, did I miss a lot of chalices? Is that why I struggled at the game so much? Mm-hmm. Oh, his feet's going through the thing. Oh, Sky Hurricane, I'm really going to have to watch your Let's Play just to see how you managed to pull through that Ants Caves boss. That was dreadful. That was so freaking difficult. Were you the same as me? Were you just biding your time and just sort of like, not waste, you were trying to conserve your ammo and all that? Because, oh my god, that was really difficult. Again, my favourite music from the game is actually back in this level. Yeah, it's from Sweet Village, it's reused in the Enchanted Earth. And I wonder if that's because, like I mentioned in my previous Let's Play, if the two levels, because they're linked, because you need to actually complete Sweet Village before you complete this one, so I think it's because the two levels are linked that they both have the same soundtrack. Okay, so we got another shield. It's only a copper shield, but it's a shield nonetheless. So we've got some money and the Earth Rune, and we'll be able to get another life vial. Oh god, I am really panicking about these new bosses. I think I'm just going to have to be supremely careful. But then again, I probably would be like that anyway, so. Dun, 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 dun. You don't really good you got it when you actually complete the game with a chalice. There we go. Yeah, don't you interrupt me, bitch. There we go. So you just enter now, nonchalant enter, but I'm gonna enter anyhow because, you know, I'm a rebel, so. I can't even talk right now because I'm just panicking about these bosses coming up because I know when I was younger I used to really struggle at these bosses. So I wonder if the next part I'll do Pull the Ancient Dead, Lake, Crystal Caves. I wonder if I'll only do three parts of this or might be done in four. I can't see it being done in any more than four parts. MediEvil 2 might be done in 4 parts 2, come think of it. So it'll probably be like an 8 part Let's Play, come think of it. So you're gonna tell me I'm doomed and all that shit, are you? Yeah. So we use the chicken drumsticks, and then will that work? Hell yeah, there we go. That's freaking awesome, that. So yeah, just use the chicken drumsticks on them. That's very beneficial. I'm not gonna waste them though, because I might need them later on. Might need to use them in the Gal's Gauntlet or something. I might save 15 drumsticks for the Gal's Gauntlet. Or 20. We'll see how I'm doing here. Top up my daggers. That's actually the only thing I could top up. So that's no wonder I've got tons of money left. No wonder I've got hella cash. Yes, I love Life is Strange, but it's another game that I really love for the PS4 actually. A lot of games I love nowadays are just mostly choice-based games, but apart from that, I'm really into my retro stuff like this. I suppose that's why I can relate to Max Caulfield. Because I'm totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face. Yay. That was quite convenient timing. Right. Wish me luck, guys. Well, they'll do me any good because I can't hear the luck. So, but thank you anyhow if you are wishing me luck. So, right. Really nervous. Really, really nervous, actually. Never, don't think I've ever had to do this before. I can't even see the full life gauge because there's no if it's in my way. Don't even know how little life I've taken off. Oh! It's coming off quite fast. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. I might be able to do this. Maybe a bit challenging, but... Oh, but the floor will keep telling, come think of it. It'll happen more frequently here. Oh, damn it. It's hard to aim with the daggers. Maybe the daggers are better than I give them credit for. Okay. And I've literally got no shield to defend myself with. The shields are pretty much useless if you're not getting any chances. Don't even know what the shields are even for, they're so useless. Oh, come on, I'm wasting so much ammo. And he's not even aiming straight, what the hell? Oh, for God's sake. See, when they're attacking me, it's sort of nudging them a little. I know, I'm probably just making excuses. But, there we go, they're almost halfway done. Oh, come on. I've actually almost lost only half a almost a life bar from defeating half of their health, so there's hope. Just keep holding down square, that's quite effective. The throwing daggers are pretty useful if you hold down square. I'm just so grateful for all the health I'll get after this round if I actually do well. I don't mind if I literally get down to my last millimeter health. All the health that I'll get in a second will be worth it. Wow. Came down to half their health bar. I'm really surprised. I thought they'd be much harder with just throwing daggers. Ah, jeez. Spoke too soon. Forgot how much harder this part would be without throwing daggers and any shields whatsoever. I'm gonna have to use the shields more often if I'm using crappier weapons. Oh. I suppose it's actually a bit more realistic because there's no way that you'd be able to carry as many weapons as Dan carries around with them every day. But it's not exactly as if games like this are realistic anyhow. It's magical. Oh, there we go, I've killed my first one. There's definitely hope for me, yeah. Oh, I'm just trying to keep my hopes up here. Oops. I'm wasting so much daggers, but I've got plenty, I think. He's almost dead. Oh, there we go. I should stop. I should only hit him once, I think, because every time I keep trying a second time, I'm always missing him. There we go. Yes! I did it! Oh my god! I still got a full life bottle in a bit. Oh my god, that was actually even easier than the Ant Queen. I'm shocked. Oh my god. Well, I am really happy with how this is going, to be honest. I don't want to say cocker tip, but oh my god, my thumb's really sore with constant tapping. But, oh god, that felt so good. It's almost like a game-gasm. So, but it topped my health back up to full. So I'm literally going to finish this level with full health. That is freaking awesome. Fair tough to that. Oh my god, my nerves have literally just gone right away right now. Dun, 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 dun. That's one of the things I was actually mainly worrying about in the game, and it's over. So another thing I'm worrying about is don't know what else I'm worrying about now. Actually, yeah, I don't even need to use chicken drumsticks on you guys, so see you later. Let's dodge all them. Just sprint to the end of level now. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, screw you! I thought things were going too well. And I can't go back up the chute to use that life phone, so I had to just make use of it while I could. You better not do this to me a second time. That chute got in my way, so... Yeah, I only lost one life ball, so that won't hurt me. And there's a life file at the start of the next level anyhow, so I'll be fine. So, won't get the chalice. And that is Enchanted Earth done chaliceless. Friggin' awesome. I'm fair chuffed with myself. Oh, no, I'm not defeating you guys, no. Well, guys, I think I'll just end this part here. Oh my god, that was brilliant. But I think I'm just going to end it here before I have a heart attack because I think I've had too much excitement for one day. But yeah, stay tuned for part 3 of MediEvil 2 after this one, before this one comes back. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you're enjoying this series so far. I'm actually quite enjoying it doing it for you, as intense as it's actually being. There's sort of a mixture of excitement in with it too. But yeah, guys, I'm really enjoying this. I can't wait to do the next part for you. See you later.